I have with us today is delinquency. Ignoble way to failure. That is how delinquency has been responsible for our failure in life. What is delinquency? It is moral deprivation. Incidentally, delinquency is associated with youth. Then we now say juvenile delinquency. But these days, we find out that every aspect of our life has been delinquent. Moral deprivation. And it has been the cause of failure of many people in this part of the world, including country. Including country, society, and all institutions. Even church is not even an institution. Church has become so delinquent that is moral laxity. And that is why our church as an institution is now in a state of poverty of spiritual information. It's not that God is no more speaking. It's not that God is no more talking. But we can't hear it again because of our state of spiritual delinquency. And that is why, for us to be successful in life, we have to address that aspect of our life. Where have I missed it out? Where does the church miss it out? Because delinquency has now become an instrument of destruction in the history of the establishment of the world empires. Marriage is an empire. And God has used marriage to complicate the society and the world entirety. But because we have been delinquent, marriage is now becoming a source of cause. Why are we even venturing into marriage? Why are we marrying marital failure? Because of moral laxity. And we have to look at this so much. Business failure and all other aspects of failure needs to be addressed, and we have to go back to the drawing board. Taking a formative interest in the collapse of the law system, I think more than every other Nigerian, because you start feeling the sense of danger in everything, including from the pastors, from the churches, and from men of God and children of God. Because we do realize one thing, that the survival of this world is on the shoulder of the Christians. So when Christians fail, the entire world in its entirety will fail. And that is why, because Christian is failing, that is why the world is failing. And if you look at the world, you will find out that it is the Christian countries that were adequately endowed with intelligence, instrument of war, instrument of development, and social orderliness. It is, you can only find it in Christian countries. Mention them: America, Britain, France, Japan. Why? Because when the descendants of the Eba, the Hebrews, where they go to establish themselves are the great countries today. But the world is failing because because of deliverance. And I want to draw out certain personalities in the Bible that are supposed to liberate people out of the yoke of poverty of oppression. I'll draw your attention to one of the personalities in the Bible, and I'll take you into the book of Judges, chapter 14, verse 23. You'll see a personality there that God had actually endowed and created to liberate the Israelites out of the yoke of oppression. Judges chapter 14 verse 23. And he came up and told his father and his mother and said, I've seen a woman in Timnah of the daughters of the Philistine. Now therefore get her for me to wife. This was the request of Samson to Manoah and his mother. But his father, then his father and his mother said unto him, is there never a woman among the daughters of my brethren? Or among all my people, that thou quest to take a wife of your circumcised minister? And Samson said unto his father, get her for me, for she is a woman. That is the animal of my decadence. It is a culture and etiquette. Different between culture and etiquette. Culture has to do with custom, and etiquette has to do with social behavior among the group of people. The culture and the etiquette of Israelites does not permit them to move out of the Israelites and look for the land. Die not with them. Die not with unequal yoke. And if you look at the history of Samson, the angel appeared to Manoah and his wife. Think not of anything ordinary and unclean food. Abide by the custom of the Israelite according to the dictate of Moses. And the father, the mother came to me. I'm going to give you a child. And that child shall what? Shall liberate Israel. And he's going to be a Nazarite. No place shall touch his head. The same person called Samson that was ordained from him lost out because he looked up to him and was circumcised. If you read further, God uses it as an instrument of temptation to the Philistines. And he did not allow Samson to have a touch of her because the parent of the girl gave the lead to an apostle. And God uses it to punish the Philistines. But if you look at Judges chapter 7 and chapter Judges chapter 16 verse 1, so God saved him in there. But when you get to Judges chapter 16 verse 1, then went Samson to Gaza and saw an harlot and went in unto her. Harlot! A prostitute. Adulterous woman. Then Samson lost out. And he fell into to die to Delilah. And he revealed the secret of the name. No man shall touch me. See how he lost out. He did not only suffer, the Israelites suffered. And Bible did not tell us that Manoah and his wife had another child till he died. See the impact, negative impact, the wayward of a personality caused his period. systems of manual became an issue, no discipline. Where is the position of church? The church out of discernment? Do we even have? Church has now been reduced to a theater of college and we have desecrated the church system. Church as an institution. Where do we sit? Delinquency is not the way to fail. If you look at all other institutions, marital institutions, marriage is collapsing at the altar of delinquency. Men of God started adulterating themselves. Polluting their body by going to strange women, abandon their wife. We are doing this. We now have downstairs church. We now have churches that no more preach morals. And our pastors and prophets of God are now encouraging all fraudulent activity. I even heard it recently that the chairman of the Economic and Financial Crime Commission in Nigeria said that the Yahoo boys more than have now formed a society. See, and the writing word says, let's not conjecture at the possibility. You cannot give what to do. If these women, the mothers, had the product of moral laxity, then who will teach the youth? Where are we, the Christian world? We are doing this. If you look at our businesses, the failure syndrome has now become endemic and has eaten deep in the fabric of our